viewers, today our topic is U for BAC characters. In this U for BAC characters, we have to observe the vegetative and floral characters. In the vegetative characters, we will discuss about the root, stem and leaves. In the root, roots are taproot system because of these are the dicotyledons. But in many hot plant, tuberous roots are present. Already we observed the tuberous roots in previous class in the economic importance U for BAC family. Then stem nature, U for BAC hopes are stops. That's why these are soft to touch. Some plants are grown as trees. Example is Philanthus emblica. Then some plants are modified as phylloclades. Example Euphorbia thirukalli. Observe the beside picture. This is Euphorbia thirukalli. Phylloclades. Phylloclade defines stem is jointed and appearance like and functioning as a leaf. This is known as phylloclades. See the diagram. In this diagram, stem is modified as leaf and functioning as leaf. Such type of phenomenon is known as phylloclades. Example is Euphorbia thirukalli. Milky latex and thick stem is in Euphorbia antiquorum. See the beside diagram, it is Euphorbia antiquorum. In this plant, milky like latex is produced and stem is thick. This is about the stem nature. Going to the leaf nature of Euphorbiaceae, leaves are simple leaves and alternative phyllotaxy, petiolate, bracteate. In some plants, bracts are glandular. Example is Jetropha. Pinnately compound leaves are present in the Philanthus. Various color leaves are present in Codium and Croton plants. See the diagrams. Beside diagram is leaf of the Philanthus. These leaves are known as pinnately compound leaves and alternative phyllotaxy. Then below pictures, this is Jetropha. In this Jetropha, we have to observe the glandular hairs. Bracts are modified as glandular. Then beside diagram is Codium and Croton. This Codium and Croton plants are having the various color leaves. This is about the vegetative characteristics of the Euphorbiaceae family. Then we will discuss about the floral characters. In this floral characters, inflorescence. In Euphorbiaceae family, different types of inflorescence is present. Those are the Cyathium, example Euphorbia, Catechin, example Acalypha, Dicarcial Cyma, example Jetropha. Solitary flowers arranged from the leaf axils, example Philanthus. Once observe the below diagram, students. In these diagrams, we have to observe the above inflorescence types. First diagram is Cyathium inflorescence, Euphorbia. Second diagram is Catechin inflorescence in Acalypha. Third diagram is Dicarcial Cymose inflorescence, Jetropha. Last picture is solitary flowers. This is solitary flower arranged from the leaf axils. It is Philanthus flower. In above these inflorescence types, Cyathium inflorescence type is very important. This Cyathium is, now we will discuss about the Cyathium. Cyathium is special type of inflorescence. It is appearance like a single flower. In this Cyathium, a deep involucre is present surrounded the inflorescence like a cup. Outer side of this cup, nectar glands are present. From this cup below region and middle region, a female flower is formed elongated from the middle part of the nectar glands. Around the female flower, many male flowers are arranged. Each male flower similar as stamen. Both male and female flowers are achlamydias. Achlamydias means there is no sepal and petal. So these are the considered as the naked flower. Flowers are blossom centrifugally. Centrifugally means flowers are arranged from the central region. That is known as centrifugally. For this Cyathium, best example is Euphorbia. One, see the diagram here. This is Cyathium. In this Cyathium, it is involucre, cup-like involucre here. From this cup-like involucre, middle region, female, elongated female flower is arranged. This is female flower. Elongated female flower is arranged. Beside region of these female flowers, many male flowers are present. Then, above the cup, on the cup, nectar glands are formed. Those male and female flowers are arranged centrifugally. Once again, see this diagram. It is cyathium. In the cyathium, this is involucre. Involucre, above region glands are present. These are the glands. From the middle region of the involucre, female flower is present. Beside region of the female flowers, male flowers are produced. Each male flower is considered as stamen. These are the stamens. Then, female flowers are trilocular and tricarpel. Both the male and female flowers are blossom centrifugally. This is in detail explanation of the cyathium. Then, flower nature. Flowers are pedicellate, bracteate, bracteolate or ebracteolate. Some are unisexual flowers, means monoecious flowers, actinomorphic, pentamerous, hypogynous flowers, achlamydias, are unichlamydias or bichlamydias flowers. For the bichlamydias flower, example plant is Jectropha. See the diagram. This diagram is belongs to the Jectropha. In this Jectropha, we have to observe the two rows of the chlamydias. In this Jectropha, two rows of tepals. One row, two row. In this first row, second row, two rows of the chlamydias are observed in the Jectropha. This is about the flower. Then, perion. Tepals are 5 in numbering. These are non-fused, nothing but free. Arranged in single row. But, croton, 2 rows of the tepals are present. These are the valvate aestivation or imbricate aestivation. See the below diagram. In this diagram, we observe the single row of tepals are 5 in numbering. Androecium. In this androecium, stamens are many in numbering. Number of stamens are vary. Examples are, in euphorbia, only one stamen is present. In philanthus, 3 to 5 stamens are present. In ricinus, 5 stamens are present. In acalypha, 8 stamens. Jectropha, 10 stamens are present. In this way, stamens are vary in numbering in euphorbiaceae family. See the diagrams. This diagram is, first diagram is, euphorbia. In euphorbia, only one stamen is present. Second diagram is a philanthus. In this philanthus, 3 to 5 stamens are present. In this diagram, we observe the 3 stamens. Next diagram is a ricinus. In the ricinus, 5 stamens are present. Next diagram is a acalypha. In this acalypha, 8 stamens are present. 8 stamens are here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then, last diagram is Jectropha. In this Jectropha, we have to observe the 10 stamens. In some plants, filaments and anthers are united. Examples are philanthus and ricinus. Another important character is observed in the ricinus. That is, branched stamens are present in the ricinus. Then, anthers are dithecous, intros, longitudinal dehys, sterile male flowers. Sterile male flowers are present in the Jectropha. Going to the female sex organ, that is gynoecium. Ovary is tricarpellary, fused, trilocular, superior ovary. Each locule has one or two ovules are arranged on axial placentation. This is the ovary. In this diagram, we clearly observe trilocular, tricarpellary ovary. Each locule has one or two ovules are present in the axial placentation. Then, style nature. Style is very short. It is slitted into trifid externally. Each style has two stigmas. One annular gland present the ovary below region in the female flower. Then, stigma. Stigma is bifid and hairy. This is about the gynoecium nature. These are the floral and vegetative characters of the Euphorbiaceae family. Pollination. Pollination through the insects. That type of pollination is known as entomophilus. After the pollination, flower is modified as fruit. Ovules are modified as in this Euphorbiaceae family, fruits are regma type of fruits and berry type of fruits. Regma means it is a physocarpic fruit, and when it is splits, it is modified as a 3 mericarps. See the diagrams. First diagram is Ricinus communis, castor, nothing but castor. In this diagram, we have to observe the tri-parpellary trilacular ovary. It is modified as 3 mericarps. Beside diagram is Philanthus, it is berry. This is about the fruit. Then seeds. Seeds are endospermic seeds. In this seeds, oils are preserved in the endosperm. Caruncle is present at seed pores. Beside diagrams are opening of seeds from the fruit. Caruncle is the one of the important question. Caruncle defines an outgrowth at the hilum of the seed. Example is castor. This caruncle is used for the dispersion of the seeds and absorption of the water. See the diagram here. This is the castor seed. In this castor seed, we observe the caruncle. This apical region is caruncle. Caruncle means an outgrowth at the hilum of the seed. This is hilum. On this hilum, an outgrowth is present. This is known as caruncle. This caruncle is used for the dispersion of seeds as well as absorption of the water. Then this is about the clear in detail explanation of the Euphorbiaceae family. Once again, I'll repeat this topic while showing this picture. This is Croton banplandianum, plant overall characters. This is small twig. These are the male flowers. In these male flowers, it is male flower floral diagram. In this male flower floral diagram, tepals are in two rows. One, two rows, five in numbering of the. In each row, five in numbering of the sepals and five in numbering of the petals are here. Then it is female flower. In this female flower, only single row of the tepals are present. This is male flower. In this male flower, stamens are in many in numbering. This is male flower. Then in the female flower, see this diagram. It is female flower. In this female flower, style. It is style. Style is slitted into trifid. It is trifid. 1, 2, 3. This is style. Each style has a bifid stigma. Each style has bifid stigma. Below the ovary, nectar glands are present. Once again, see this floral diagram of the female flower. In this female flower, we observe the tepals in single row, 5 in numbering, and central region of this floral diagram, tricarpellary trilacular ovary is present. In each lacule, one or two ovules are arranged in the axil placentation. This is about the in-detail explanation of the Euphorbiaceae family. This is original picture of the Croton banplandianum. Okay, thank you for watching this video.